Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage former president and CEO of Qurate Retail, Mike George.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to NRF 2022 Retail's Big Show. It is just so wonderful to be back in New York City at this beautiful, newly renovated Javits Center. We're all here, we're vaccinated, we're masked up, we're tested, but most importantly, we're together. We're together for NRF's 112th annual Big Show. And this team has assembled an exceptional program despite all the obstacles. More than 700 exhibits, 190 sessions, and upwards of 300 speakers. We've expanded the very popular Innovation Lab and the Startup Zone. We've added three new pavilions to the expo, featuring specialized vendors in supply chain, e-commerce, food service. And the NRF team has worked so diligently to do all this, to put together this great show, while staying focused on your health and your safety, and responding to the ever-evolving news of the day about Omicron, to make sure we could put on a safe show, just as all of you have been doing to try to keep your retail store operations running safely through this crisis. It has been 2 years, right? It's been 2 years since we gathered here in person. And together we have come through a remarkable set of challenges. In 2020, the pandemic put the world on hold. But retail never stopped. We kept moving forward, striving, evolving to meet the rapidly changing needs of our customers and our communities. We stepped up. We played the essential role in making sure people could safely access food and cleaning supplies, home office equipment, fitness gear, whatever they needed to keep moving. We moved outside, we moved online, and we moved out of our lanes. And as we always do, we experimented. We innovated, we invented, we found whole new ways to serve customers better, all while doing everything possible to protect their health and the health and safety of our employees, our vendor partners, and our communities. And then in 2021, as effective vaccines became widely available, as federal stimulus took hold, the economy surged ahead, and we continued to innovate. We enhanced the in-store experience based on new insights learned through the pandemic. We found new ways to merge digital and physical shopping. We increased our use of video to create more robust, more immersive experiences. Some of us even entered the metaverse. Over the past 2 years, our willingness to embrace change, to find a better way, no matter the incredible obstacles, to evolve and innovate faster than anyone thought possible, all this has been essential to keeping the economy and keeping our industry moving forward. And now that consumers know what we're capable of, they expect it. That's why our theme for this year's Big Show is Accelerate. We all get that we can't slow down. We need to keep speeding up, keep doing more to delight our customers in this unpredictable environment. So my challenge for all of us is to use the next few days as an opportunity to learn from one another so together we can accelerate our industry. So let's pause to take a look at the state of retail as we enter this show, as we enter 2022. We have seen a tremendous recovery from the depths of the pandemic, with year-over-year sales growth for 20 consecutive months. In fact, retail sales grew 14% in 2021. That's the highest rate in over 20 years, on top of 7% growth in 2020. All of it culminating in a record holiday season despite inflation, despite supply shortages, despite labor shortages, despite renewed concerns about the pandemic. And every category performed well. Every category is now above pre-pandemic levels of spending, and many, of course, have surged well ahead. And as you know, this growth didn't just come from e-commerce. If you remove non-store sales, 2021 store sales also grew 14%. Remarkable. And I think what's most striking about our industry today is the broad and balanced performance we're enjoying. Retail business applications averaged over 81,000 a month in 2021. That's over double the 2019 average. The number of U.S. stores hit its highest level in a decade in Q2, with over 1 million stores. E-commerce levels peaked in April of 2020. That was the height of the mandatory store closures, the stay-at-home orders, hitting 19% of all retail sales. Since then, e-commerce levels have dropped back to 15%, but are still above pre-pandemic levels. And finally, retail foot traffic is beginning to come back. December traffic was well above last year and over 80% of the levels that we enjoyed 2 years ago. And while consumers are clearly excited, thrilled to get back into stores, they're not simply returning to what they were doing in 2019. We all know that. We all know that the new normal will look different. Our customers increasingly want a more integrated, seamless shopping experience, digital and physical, personalized and local, experience that meet them wherever, whenever, however they want to shop. And customers are at times seeking ever more quick and convenient ways to shop, and at other times searching for more immersive, more experiential, more inspiring, more social, more human ways to shop. Now, this is particularly true among the older generation. They report that they're more comfortable now with buy online, pick up in store, or pick up at curbside, more comfortable with online grocery ordering. A new study from NRF and IBM found that over half of global consumers, over half, have tried self-checkout, and another 47% have tried mobile contactless payment options. And recent research from Deloitte tells us that 80% of consumers value convenience more than they did pre-pandemic, 80% expect flexible shipping and fulfillment options, and nearly 90% expect companies to keep investing in digital. And digital innovation is happening everywhere. It's happening at big national chains, at smaller businesses, at local shops. Everyone adopting new technologies as never before, improving the consumer experience, creating new efficiencies, new capabilities. According to Euromonitor, 72% of global retail professionals say that the pandemic has accelerated their company's digital transformation by at least a year. I think for many of us, it feels like by many years. And so we're entering 2022. Our industry is entering 2022 in a strong position, arguably the strongest position we have enjoyed in many, many years. But all of you know that we're also facing incredible challenges. And we are so fortunate to have a strong ally at our sides in the NRF, in Matt Shea and his wonderful team, to help us navigate this absolutely unique moment. We're experiencing an historically tight labor market, almost a million retail job openings, And the NRF is there to help us, convening retailers to share best practices on recruitment and retention, providing education and resources to bring more people into retail, especially through the absolutely vital, important work of the NRF Foundation that many of you support, advocating for citizenship for Dreamers and other sensible immigration rules. And we're facing worldwide supply chain challenges, disruptions that continue to complicate retail imports, raising costs and inflation. We're seeing congestion in the U.S. ports, we're seeing shortages of overseas containers, we're seeing bottlenecks in truck and rail capacity, and so much more. It's impacting every one of you. NRF successfully supported the $1.2 trillion Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act with new funding for our roads, bridges, rail networks, ports, new policies to address the critical truck driver shortage. And now Matt and team are focused on new legislation to reform ocean shipping. And of course, COVID-19 is still with us. And despite the demonstrated track record of vaccines in reducing the risk of serious illness or death, vaccination rates have stalled, especially among young Americans. The proportion of people in the U.S. who have received at least one vaccine dose is the lowest of any G7 country. Only about 63% of Americans are fully vaccinated against the virus. That level is tragically too low. Achieving high vaccination rates is critical to sustaining retail, to sustaining the economic recovery. And for many months, NRF and retailers nationwide have been working together to encourage retail employees to get vaccinated. But we recently also faced a federal mandate for employer-based vaccination and testing that we found to just be unworkable. And so the NRF has been our advocate for more sensible ways to promote the absolutely shared goal of vaccination. In November, the NRF won a court order delaying implementation of the new mandate to allow time for more dialogue, to rework it. And on Thursday, as you saw, the Supreme Court affirmed this decision, blocking implementation of the mandate. These are just a few of the areas where the NRF is advocating on our behalf. And as we look forward, as we look into 2022, the NRF will be advancing a number of critical policy priorities to strengthen the global supply chain, to improve trade conditions and lower tariffs, to attract and retain a high-quality workforce to retail, to protect a pro-growth economy, to continue to assist small businesses as they struggle to recover from the pandemic, to promote a national standard, wouldn't that be nice, for privacy protection, to assist retail as it embraces sustainable business practices, and to equip local, state, and federal authorities with the tools to combat the growing crisis of organized retail crime. And the NRF will continue to bring us together, continue to be our convener. We're thrilled to debut two new events this year, our inaugural NRF Supply Chain 360 in Cleveland in June. We'll convene retail's leading supply chain and sustainability professionals to address ongoing supply chain challenges, including the modes and methods of needed to build a faster and a more sustainable retail supply chain. And our inaugural NRF Nexus in California in July, designed specifically for senior leaders in marketing and technology and digital and innovation, will bring together 300 of our industry's best and brightest to debate cutting-edge ideas and share best practices. Registration is open for both events. We'd love to see many of you there. Let me just wrap up by saying that I think we should all feel tremendously proud of our industry's accomplishments, all of your accomplishments during this past year and throughout this dreadful pandemic. You know, our success as an industry has always been predicated on the dedication and the passion of our people, and our ability to respond effectively to what the customer was telling us, to keep adapting to their ever-evolving needs, while the pandemic just added extraordinary challenges to that work. And while we all fervently hope, as Omicron begins to peak across the country, that we'll find that the worst days of this are behind us, it's still hard to predict what the virus may have in store for us in 2022. And yet we enter the year with great confidence because we have shown, you have all shown, tremendous agility over the past 2 years, proving our ability to deliver safe, convenient, and yes, inspiring shopping in the face of unprecedented challenges. We have been there for our customers when they needed us the most. We have been there for our customers when they needed us the most, and they have rewarded us with tremendous growth amidst great adversity. We're ready. We're ready to accelerate in 2022, no matter what circumstances we face. And NRF will be there with us. NRF will be bringing us together, continuing to advocate for the success of our industry. So thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here to experience NRF 2022 Retail's Big Show. I hope you have a wonderful program. Thank you.